Now to lamb. This is a stuffed shoulder of lamb, Judy. New Zealand lamb is ideal for this recipe, and it's nice and cheap. And to use something like a shoulder is well worthwhile, because it's much, much cheaper to stuff than a leg. Mm. I think this is about 50, just over, per pound, whereas a leg would be 80, just over. Mm.
And if it's frozen, which it obviously would be, a New Zealand lamb, then you must do it slowly, mustn't you?
Thaw it slowly. Indeed, yes. Because you can see this is absolutely bone dry, and that's because I thawed it slowly in the fridge.
Mm.
I've already taken the bone out, Judy.
Is that a difficult job?
Not really. There's the bone. Get your butcher to do it if you're at all nervous of doing it.
But otherwise, keep the knife absolutely close to the bone all the way around, and then it should come out like that.
Then it'll be nice and clean.
Yeah.
And I'm going to make a nice stuffing of breadcrumbs, 2 ounces of breadcrumbs, a small can this size of apricots chopped, salt and pepper, and a fried onion.
Which you've already partly fried, haven't you?
That's right. I find that to put raw onion in a stuffing makes it, very rarely does it get cooked in the time. And plenty of chopped parsley, 2 tablespoonfuls.
Lovely and green.
That's generous, isn't it?
I've just put some in the garden, is that all right?
I thought you meant you put it in here. Yes, I put some in a few weeks ago. I gather it's now still mild and it's still growing and you should get it. I think you put a cloche over it and you get it at Christmas time.
Yes, and I'm hoping that's what's going to happen.
And then bind together with egg. 1 beaten egg. There we are.
Puts it all in.
Now it's got to be well seasoned and then you'll get a good stuffing. So I've opened up where it's really sort of slitting the joint in half. I've opened it up and then I'm going to put the stuffing in. Just going to squeeze it together. There we are. It's nice and moist. There we are. Put the lid over again. You take that bowl. Thank you. It's a real sticky job today, isn't it? And then you want to roll the joint up like that and tie it with string. And I've got one started, Judy. And I think that's easier than doing a whole long process.
Of course, you can skewer the lamb, presumably, now, if you just want to skewer it rather than tie it up professionally.
A skewer is... Now, believe it or not, I've only got 2 short skewers left. My children are conquering at the moment, and
All children conquering?
They're bent, I found them. And also, I had to buy a brand new ball of string, because you know where that's gone, and bootlaces.
Yes.
Start off with making a knot. There's the end. Start off, it's like Christmas parcels, making an ordinary knot, a single knot, and then you use that as a slip knot for the end. So you would put that round the end, like catching a rabbit, and pull it up. And I've done that and started it all along here. Then you want to do this. Having done one slip knot, you put it underneath and then pull it like that. And you make a lovely pattern all the way down.
It's very professional.
It's quicker with skewers, but yeah. You'll get it neater like that all the way down. You notice I didn't skin it, didn't need it, it wasn't tough. Turn it over with the stuffing in, and then you loop it
all the way down,
yes. And then tie it at the end in a knot, like that, double knot, and then turn it over, and it's ready for roasting.
And when you roast it, you've got one in the oven, haven't you?
Yes. Roast it about 400 degrees Fahrenheit.
I'll come over with
you.
Or
a little bit lower.
Yeah. I didn't have any string yesterday either because of the conkers. I Mark's party to tie the balloons up.
There we are. The string's...
Oh, that looks delicious.
Still firmly holding it together, Judy. There's the stuffing oozing out, which looks rather nice. And it will take about 30 minutes to the pound. You can do it slightly less than 400 if you wish. There we are. There's that stuffing, Judy. Can you see?
Absolutely
the
super.
The lovely pink...
What would you serve that with, Mary?
I would cook potatoes and onions in the oven, layered in slices in the oven at the same time as I was cooking the meat, and that would save a bit of fuel.
What about the meat that we're going on to now? It's another piece of lamb, isn't it? But a different part this time.
This is the very cheapest part of lamb that you can get, and I think a jolly good buy. Now, a whole breast of lamb will maybe cost you about 15 pence, or That's in some butchers, or it's about 22 pence a pound for English or for New Zealand.
So in this case, you've bought English because they're the same price?
Yes. When you're buying one, make sure you buy quite a wide one. Mm. That's off a fairly big lamb, and then you've got more meat on it. Now, as you can see, they're not really very fatty, but before you start, you want to take off any surplus fat, because most families don't like an abundance of fat, and then you'll find in the top here, you see that piece there?
Yes. You take that out as well.
Just take that out and take this.
How do you...
Sharp knife.
Yes.
And off here, there's quite a big thick piece there. I don't like too much extra fat. And with a recipe that uses this breast of lamb, I find it best to start off by frying it. And here, the skin is quite smooth and not tough, and so there's no need to take it off. Sometimes it's dry, and if it is, you can just take it off with a sharp knife. Mm. Start off, this is red hot lamb. It's a spicy recipe, and start off by cutting the meat into slices.
What happens when you get to the bone bits?
I'm just coming to that. Yes, you can do that quite easily, Judy. If you haven't got sharp knives, you can get your butcher to do it. You can sort of break it here yourself. Mm. I can. There we are. And just go through with a sharp knife.
To prove it, she did it.
And to prove it, she did it. But you may find it a little bit tough, and if you do, then you can get your butcher to do it for you. Just slice it all the way down. Mm. But cut that into pieces. It's you can do pork in this very same way if you wish.
Like spare ribs, you mean?
That's right.
Now, you say you've partly cooked those already, have you?
Yes.
Fried?
Because the outside is fatty, I've already started the recipe, and you need 2 pounds of... the breast of lamb, and I've fried it well. That takes off the surplus fat and it makes it all nice and crisp. So that's fried. And let's
is that in dripping? Is that fried?
Yes, well, dripping's free. Mm. It's come off a joint usually. So those are all browned, and I've taken off any surplus fat. The little bit of fat that was left, I've started to brown the onions in, and that's taken up the fat. And I'm going to thicken it slightly with a little flour. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to use a tablespoonful of flour, level, and then we come to the other seasonings. And the reason why it's red hot, it's nice and spicy, is because it's got a bit of curry powder in. And I'm going to put a tablespoonful of curry powder.
Goodness.
Well, that's not very much. You put much more in a curry. Not a very generous one, according to how hot you like things. And 2 teaspoonfuls of tomato puree, and if you're only using a small amount of tomato puree, I find it best to
use the tube.
Yes, it's less wasteful.
I do too. Yes. And then keep the end rolled up like a tube of toothpaste.
That's right. So just stir those, just turn the heat up a second to absorb the flour. Put that in on top. There we are. Then to the other ingredients. A full can of tomatoes, and that's a 14-ounce can. 3/4 a pint of stock.
That's meat stock, obviously.
That's right. And then pepper and salt.
Don't know what we do without those, do you?
And some onion, some carrot. That's optional. I've put a large carrot in, sliced.
Mm. This takes a fair while to cook, doesn't it?
It does, and put a little garlic in if your family likes it.
One with your garlic crusher.
That's right. Yeah. I've left the skin on because I find that inside it collects the skin and I don't get my hands smelling of it.
Mm. How long do you... You can either cook that presumably in the oven or on the top, can you?
There we are. Yes, I usually cook it in the oven because I've got other things in the oven at the same time. Mm. Put the lid on and I usually bring it to the boil on top of the stove, and then put it in the oven and cook
about
it slowly, 2 hours. Because the outside is fatty, I've already started the recipe, and you need 2 pounds of the breast of lamb, and I've fried it well. That takes off the surplus fat, and it makes it all nice and crisp. So that's fried. And let's
is that in dripping? Is that fried?
Yes, well, dripping's free. Mm. It's come off a joint usually. So those are all browned, and I've taken off any surplus fat. The little bit of fat that was left, I've started to brown the onions in, And that's taken up the fat. And I'm going to thicken it slightly with a little flour. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to use a tablespoonful of flour, level. And then we come to the other seasonings. And the reason why it's red hot, it's nice and spicy, is because it's got a bit of curry powder in. And I'm going to put a tablespoonful of curry powder.
Oh, now, goodness.
Well, that's not very much. You put much more in a curry. Not a very generous one, according to how hot you like things. And 2 teaspoonfuls of tomato puree. And if you're only using a small amount of tomato puree, I find it best to...
use the tube.
Yes, it's less wasteful.
Yes, I do too. Yes. And then keep the end rolled up like a tube of toothpaste.
That's right. So just stir those, just turn the heat up a second to absorb the flour. Put that in on top. There we are. Then to the other ingredients, a full can of tomatoes, and that's a 14-ounce can. 3/4 pint of stock.
Professional.
It's quicker with skewers, but yeah. You'll get it neater like that all the way down. You notice I didn't skin it, didn't need it, it wasn't tough. Turn it over with the stuffing in, and then you loop it all the way down, and then tie it at the end in a knot. Like that, double knot, and then turn it over, and it's ready for roasting.
And when you roast it, you've got one in the oven, haven't you?
Yes. Roast it about 400 degrees Fahrenheit.
I'll come over with
you. Or a little bit lower.
Yeah. I didn't have any string yesterday either because of the conkers. I Mark's party to tie the balloons up.
There we are. The string's...
Oh, that looks delicious.
Still firmly holding it together, Judy. Mm. There's the stuffing oozing out. It looks rather nice, and it will take about 30 minutes to the pound. You can do it slightly less than 400 if you wish. There we are. There's that stuffing, Judy. Can you see?
Absolutely
the
super.
The lovely pink.
What would you serve that with, Mary?
I would cook potatoes and onions in the oven, layered in slices in the oven at the same time as I was cooking the meat, and that would save a bit of fuel.
What about the meat that we're going on to now? It's another piece of lamb, isn't it? But a different part this time.
This is the very cheapest part of lamb that you can get. And I think a jolly good buy. Now, a whole breast of lamb will maybe cost you about 15 pence. Or that's in some butchers. Or it's about 22 pence a pound for English or for New Zealand.
So in this case, you've bought English because they're the same price.
Now to lamb. This is a stuffed shoulder of lamb, Judy. New Zealand lamb is ideal for this recipe, and it's nice and cheap. And to use something like a shoulder is well worthwhile because it's much, much cheaper to stuff than a leg. Mm. I think this is about 50, just over, per pound, whereas a leg would be 80, just over. Mm.
And if it's frozen, which it obviously would be, a New Zealand lamb, then you must do it slowly, mustn't you?
Thaw it slowly. Indeed, because you can see this is absolutely bone dry, and that's because I thawed it slowly in the fridge. Mm. I've already taken the bone out, Judy.
Is that a difficult job?
Not really. There's the bone. Get your butcher to do it if you're at all nervous of doing it.
But otherwise, keep the knife absolutely close to the bone all the way around, and then it should come out like that.
Then it'll be nice and clean.
Yeah.
And I'm going to make a nice stuffing of breadcrumbs, 2 ounces of breadcrumbs, a small can this size of apricots chopped, salt and pepper, and a fried onion.
Which you've already partly fried, haven't you?
That's right. Mm. I find that to put raw onion in a stuffing makes it, very rarely does it get cooked in the time. Mm. And plenty of chopped parsley, 2 tablespoonfuls.
Lovely and green.
That's generous, isn't it?
I've just put some in the garden, is that all right?
I thought you meant you put it in here. Yes, I put some in a few weeks ago. I gather it's now still mild and it's still growing and you should get it. I think you put a cloche over it and you get it at Christmas time.
Yes, and I'm hoping that's what's going to happen.
And then bind together with egg. 1 beaten egg. Mm. There we are.
Puts it all in.
Now it's got to be well seasoned and then you'll get a good stuffing. So I've opened up where it's really sort of slitting the joint in half. I've opened it up and then I'm going to put the stuffing in. Just going to squeeze it together. There we are. It's nice and moist. There we are. Put the lid over again. You take that bowl. Mm-hmm. Thank you. It's a real sticky job today, isn't it? And then you want to roll the joint up like that and tie it with string. And I've got one started, Judy. Mm. And I think that's easier than doing a whole long process.
Of course, you can skewer the lamb, presumably, now, if you just want to skewer it rather than tie it up professionally.
You can. A skewer is... Now, believe it or not, I've only got two short skewers left. My children are conquering at the moment, and I've none.
All children conquering.
They're bent, I found them. And also, I had to buy a brand new ball of string, because you know where that's gone. And bootlaces.
Yes.
Start off with making a knot. There's the end. Start off, it's like Christmas parcels, making an ordinary knot, a single knot. And then you use that as a slip knot for the end. So you would put that round the end, like catching a rabbit, and pull it up. And I've done that and started it all along here. Then you want to do this. Having done one slip knot, you put it underneath and then pull it like that. And you make a lovely pattern all the way down. Yes, when you're buying one, make sure you buy quite a wide one. Mm. That's off a fairly big lamb, and then you've got more meat on it. Now, as you can see, they're not really very fatty, but before you start, you want to take off any surplus fat, because most families don't like an abundance of fat, and then you'll find in the top here, you see that piece there?
Yes, you take that out as well.
Just take that out and take this.
How do you...
Sharp knife.
Yes.
And off here, there's quite a big thick piece there. I don't like too much extra fat. And with a recipe that uses this breast of lamb, I find it best to start off by frying it. And here, the skin is quite smooth and not tough, and so there's no need to take it off. Sometimes it's dry, and if it is, you can just take it off with a sharp knife. Mm. Start off, this is red hot lamb. It's a spicy recipe, and start off by cutting the meat into slices.
What happens like when that? You get to the bone bits?
I'm just coming to that. Yes, you can do that quite easily, Judy. If you haven't got sharp knives, you can get your butcher to do it. You can sort of break it here yourself. Mm. I can. There we are. And just go through with a sharp knife.
To prove it, she did it.
But you may find it a little bit tough, and if you do, then you can get your butcher to do it for you. Just slice it all the way down.
Mm.
But cut that into pieces. It's you can do pork in this very same way if you wish.
Like spare ribs, you mean?
That's right.
Now, you say you've partly cooked those already, have you?
Yes.
Fried?